The following tools are required to perform the lamp change: a flathead screwdriver, a 4mm torque wrench, a 17mm open-ended wrench, a 17mm torque wrench, and a 3mm Allen key. Turn off the main electrical breaker to the projector. Remove the projector cover to the lamphouse compartment. Loosen all three spring-loaded captive bolts that lock the lamphouse to the projector. Hold the lamphouse by top and bottom handles at the rear of the lamphouse and pull the lamphouse out of the projector. Caution, the lamphouse is fairly heavy. Place the lamphouse on a stable surface. Use a 5mm torque wrench or Allen key to remove the cathode bolt that is located at the rear of the lamphouse. Ensure that all protective gear is currently being worn. This includes the lint-free protective gloves, the face shield, and the welder's jacket. Remove the side cover of the lamphouse by loosening the retaining thumb screws and lifting the cover off of the lamphouse. Reach into the lamphouse and support the anode of the lamp by holding the metal anode part of the lamp. This ensures that the lamp doesn't fall out when the UV blocker mounting plate is removed. Remove the UV blocker mounting plate by loosening four retaining thumb screws on the front of the cover. Slide the white anode socket up and out of its holder by pulling it straight up. Pull the lamp out of the lamphouse while ensuring that the lamp comes out straight and doesn't hit any part of the lamphouse. Place the lamp into a protective lamp container or, like in this situation, in a lamp cloth and secure it. Remove the anode cable from the anode socket by using both 17mm wrenches to loosen the locking nuts on the anode terminal. Remove the cathode adapter off of the lamp by loosening the locking screw with a 5mm Allen key, and then by twisting the adapter counterclockwise until the adapter comes off. Replace the old lamp with the new xenon lamp. While the new lamp is still in the protective cover, attach the cathode lamp adapter to the lamp by tightening the adapter clockwise until tension is felt. Once tension is felt, use a 5mm Allen key to tighten the locking screw on the adapter. Tighten to the torque specifications as listed in the manual. Attach the anode cable of the lamp to the anode socket and tighten the locking nuts on the anode terminal to the torque specifications as listed in the manual by using both 17mm wrenches. Remove the retaining straps from the protective cloth. Insert the lamp into the lamphouse by lining up the lamp with the hole that the lamp came out of. Ensure that the anode cable is facing down. Slide the white anode socket down into its holder by pushing it straight down into the first metal opening. Ensure that you place the adapter into the opening of the front plate. While supporting the front of the lamp, remount the UV blocker mounting plate with anode support onto the lamphouse. Once the UV blocker mounting plate is on, Tighten the four retaining locking thumb screws to secure it. Keep fingerprints off of the UV blocker during this process. Next, double-check that the cathode connector in front of the lamphouse is tightened to the torque specifications in the manual. This is very important, as it may have come loose over time. Remove the protective cloth from the lamp. Place the side cover back onto the lamphouse and tighten the two retaining locking thumb screws to secure the side panel. Insert the cathode bolt back into the rear of the lamphouse with a 5mm torque wrench and tighten to the proper torque specifications. Hold the lamphouse by the rear handles and insert into the projector. Ensure the lamphouse is properly seated. Tighten all three spring-loaded captive bolts that lock the lamphouse to the projector. Install the projector cover to the lamphouse compartment. Reset the lamp type and lamp hours in the communicator software. See the communicator manual for more details.